this is not a clue or bed of worms. It is one individual. The spaghetti worm. Despite its long, thin tentacles that can reach up to 1.5 metres in length, their bodies only reach about 15 centimetres or 6 inches. It scours the ocean floor for detritus, small dead organisms and sea snow. When it retracts these finely grooved tentacles, it is not only collecting lunch, but other small particles that it uses to build up its tube. Usually, all you'll ever see of this worm is the spaghetti-like tentacles sprawled across the ocean floor. But sometimes you might see its branched gills poking out of the top of its tubular home. It has an exoskeleton up to 9 feet long. Retractable mandibles that can slice prey in half. And yet, it is blind. But it can strike in the blink of an eye. The sand striker, or bobbit worm, is a benthic bristle worm. According to fossil records, they have been ambushing prey like this for 20 million years. They have a primary pair of mandibles and 4 to 6 pairs of maxillae, or jaw bones. Their bite injects a narcotic toxin into the prey, immobilizing it for safe consumption. Bristle worms, scale worms, rag worms, feather worms, tube worms, sandworms. They can be found right across the globe in all the planet's oceans, from the cold abyssal plains to the extreme temperatures of hydrothermal vents. G'day folks, and welcome to the Wow Factor. Let's have a look at some not so creepy worms. Another detritus feeder, the acorn worm, is the vacuum cleaner of the ocean floor. The body is made up of 3 main parts, the acorn-shaped proboscis at the front, a short fleshy collar behind it, which is where the mouth is located, and a long worm-like trunk. So named because of the acorn-shaped proboscis, they can range in size from 2 centimetres to 2.5 metres or 8 feet in length. Eating sand or mud off the ocean floor, they extract organic debris into their digestive system, which only consists of an esophagus and intestine. There is no stomach. The processed sediment is then left behind them in trails on the ocean floor. Teuthododrilus samae, I think we'll stick to squid worm, is a free-swimming annelid worm. Only discovered in 2007, it feeds on marine snow and can grow to about 9 centimetres or 3.5 inches in length. It dwells in the demersal zone of around 100 metres from the sea floor at a depth of up to 3,000 metres or over 9,800 feet. Its common name derives from the 10 squid-like appendages emerging from its head. Tomopterus the gossamer worm. A planktonic polychaete worm that spends its entire life in the water column. Generally, they only grow to a few centimetres in length. They seem to like to dance also. And what do we have here? No, not the grumpy looking rock. The fluffy yellow thing next to it. Yes, that. Let's see if the Nautilus ROV can grab it. Easy now. What? Ah yes, I see. It's a yellow terribilid worm in the family of bristle worms. Most bristle worms are sessile, meaning they have no means of locomotion. They are either attached to something, in a tube, or floating with the current. Some burrow in the sand, and some, like this little fella, can swim. Well, wriggle at least. I wouldn't want to be near that grumpy rock either.
Thanks for dropping in today, folks. Let me know in the comments what you thought of today's video. That stuff really helps. And if you did enjoy today's video, I'd love it if you give that like button a whack and subscribe for more content. Also, let me know what you'd like to see in future episodes. Anyway, look after yourself, look after your loved ones, look after this beautiful planet we call home. See you next time.